The question is, heights of 10 girls were measured in centimeters and results are as follows. So these are the heights of 10 girls and these heights are in centimeters. So the question first is saying you have to tell the height of tallest girl. Before analyzing the question, I'll tell you one trick. Either you can actually look at all the values and identify, that is the most basic and the most general method that all of us follow. But the other method and the better method would be that if you arrange that all the values in increasing or decreasing order, that would help you analyze this value better way. So let us write this in increasing order. What is the lowest value out of all these? It is 128. So we write down 128. After 128, we don't have 129, 130, 131, 132 we have two times. So I'll write 132 and 132. Next, 133 is not there. 144, 133, 134, 135. Yes, we have 135. So we write down 135. 136, 137, 138, 139. We write down 139. 140, 141, yes. 142, 143, again. 144, 145, 146, yes. 147, 148, 149. 146 is done, 149 is done. Then 150 and 151. So I have arranged my data in increasing order now. So let us answer the first question, height of the tallest girl. Now over here you can see that the data has been written in increasing order. So the largest value is 151. So height of the tallest girl is 151 centimeters. Clear? Let us answer the second question now. The second question is asking height of the shortest girl. Because we have already arranged the data, we can clearly see the lowest value is 128. So we write 128 centimeters as the second answer. What about the third one? The third is saying range of data. Now, as we discussed, how is range calculated? Range is the difference between the highest and the lowest value. So we have both the values already taken out. So we'll subtract them. That is, the range would be equal to 151 minus 128, that is equal to 23. That means 23 centimeters is the range of the given data. Next, fourth question is, you have to find the mean height of girls. Now, mean height is the same, that is sum of observations divided by number of observations. So we'll calculate this by adding up all the observations, which were 128 plus 132 plus 132 plus 135 plus 139 plus 141 plus 143 plus 146 plus 149 plus 150 plus 151 whole divided with how many number of observations were there? 10. So we will get on solving all this as 141.4. So the mean of data come out to be 141.4 centimeters. Now answering the last part, that is, you have to find how many girls have the height more than mean height. Now, because you have already calculated the mean height, which is 141.4, we can see how many heights will be lying more than this. But for that, what should be done? We have to arrange the data in increasing order. Reason being, because that would help us in a better way. Say, you can check over here also, in this way also. But here it becomes more difficult because it will be taking a longer time. So what should be done? You can arrange this in increasing order and check which values are going higher than 141.4. But because I've already done that in the first part, so I'll do it in the same way. right? So how many values are greater than 141.4? They are 1, 2, 3 and 4 plus 1, 5. That means 141.4 is going to lie somewhere here, right? That means I have all these and all these values as the values which are greater than 141.4 centimeters. So how many girls are having height more than 141.4 centimeters? There are 5 girls who are having the height of more than 141.4 centimeters.